Hello guys, it is Danny here again, and today it is another video of League Racing. It's another episode of my AOR highlights. And this weekend I will not improvise any of my commentary. I haven't written any script, but as you can see from the title, it will be such an exciting race that you don't even realize my commentary, because there will be full of action, mainly in the second part of the video. So I definitely recommend you to stay here. And meanwhile, I show you my first attempt of the quali. As you can see, it was like quite a safe lap. I fast forwarded it, I didn't really miss the apex. It was like a safe lap to not start from the last position, basically. And after that, with this exit, I start to complete the fastest lap of my qualifying session, because later on in the video you will see what happened and why it is my fastest lap as the first stint lap. I didn't have the best exit because the last corner could have been wider, but all in all the first sector was okay. In the second corner I missed the apex just a very little bit, but I carried the right momentum. Here again I cut and I go as wide as I can, and I carried a nice momentum, and here I didn't miss the apex neither. So far it was a great lap for me for the first stint tires, and these tires already completed a full lap, so yeah, it was quite nice, I believe. Here I lost the back end a little bit, but all in all with this I didn't lose time. As I thought, I hit every apex very good, and I didn't choose the whole track all time. Sometimes I could have go a little bit wider, but I didn't want to get this lap invalidated, because as you can see from the data, I was more than 2 tenths up on my time. So yeah, it was quite nice, and I really wanted to complete that lap because it gives me a safe top 10 position. After, I know that I will have only one more chance, because I planned to come into the pit and fuel the car for only one fast lap and wait until the very end of the qualifying session. And because of that, I was very focusing on that one specific lap, and I knew that it's all or nothing, basically, because if you lose that lap, you lose a lot of time, because the track at this stage is much better, it's much more grippy, my tire is better as well, because for that one lap it will be only like a 0% tire. On the other hand, the fastest lap tire was already completed 2 laps, so I mean the tire is better, the car is lighter, the track surface is more grippy because of the rubber. And arriving to the first corner, I broke at the same moment, but you can just see that the car just sticked in, and I lost time because of that, because you shouldn't hit the curb on the inside. Here I gain a little bit of time back, and all in all it's not a bad first sector. I have a lot of time to improve. I'm still in purple, but I go just like 2 centimeters wide, or I don't even go wide, you can decide it yourself. I feel that one wheel was on the line at every moment, and the line is the part of the track, and because of that we are starting P6, but in this game the line is not on the track, we see. I had an average getaway, Carrick's behind me, the Ferrari had a very very good getaway, he wanted to come into the slipstream as well, so pushed me a little bit to the inside line when I was blocked because of my teammate, and I didn't want to damage myself, I didn't want to lose any front wing, so I lost the position again at the start, which is not ideal at all. And here I tried to just stick behind Carrick's and maybe attack my teammate in that way, but he just goes wide, he loses a lot of momentum. I tried from the outside, but I don't want to get into a risky move, and if I could have kept my car there, it would have been still a corner cutting, I guess, or a track extending penalty, or at least a warning. So I didn't risk that. I know that this race is 35 laps. On the other hand, I really wanted to overtake a few cars in the first lap, because this is probably one of the hardest track to overtake, and I feel like even in Singapore I can overtake better, and only Monaco is the track where I can't overtake as much as I can hear. Here are the last sector, or the last two sectors are built from very fast corners, left and right, and it's so hard to keep the car very close, and it's so hard to press the throttle as early as you want, and it's so hard to lose the back end because of the turbulent air effect existing in 2017, and that's why the straights are long, or sorry, the straights are short, and you basically can't really get close, even if the car in front doesn't have any slipstream. But as you can see, Garrix now gets an extra momentum in the straights because there are cars ahead of him as well, and because he will have slipstream and he will have DRS, I really have no chance to overtake. And at this moment I was thinking about the new strategy, I was thinking about the two stops, because the plan was a one stop strategy, but I also wanted to save my tires to see how the others choose to play, and if I can save my tires and maybe go a little bit longer, then maybe I can do some kind of overcut on them. But I quickly realized that there are so many cars ahead that I want to overtake, and I don't want to get a P7, I don't want to get a P6, neither a P5, I want to get a higher position. So because of that thing, I chose to go to the pit and do a riskier strategy. Before this weekend, I didn't practice at all, to be honest. I only completed a few time trial runs and like 2 or 3 qualifying sessions, and I did like 10 race laps in total, so I didn't know really the strategy, I didn't know the tire rest, so for me it was like a little bit safer as well. And the season is still long, so I have like many more chances to fight back against Brandon Lee, against Marcel Kiefer, who are fantastically driving at the front. So yes, I have like plenty of time, and as you can see, I already like gained a lot of advantage on Bono Huis, who just came one lap later to the pit, and he was very much behind me before that, so you can see how effective the undercut works. But speaking of, yes, the championship, it's still long, and in the past few weeks I couldn't practice that much because of school, and the year is ending for us, the school ends in June, so we have a lot of exams, and that's why I just try to have exciting races for you to upload. I try to keep my second place in the championship. Brandon Lee is nearly uncatchable. He is practicing a lot, and he is a very talented pilot. And as you can see, I undercut even Brandon Lee, and he was leading the race. So that's how effective undercut is, and I am already like P5 and attacking for P4, but I need to complete another pit stop. And here I thought Raven would let me pass, but he just defended the inside line, and I don't know which or why it was like so aggressive defending, but I'm okay with that. I had a much better grip with the new tires, so I just brake very late and go softly around the outside, and for me it was like a very very exciting move, but like a move that I had to do because I can't lose time behind cars who haven't pitted yet. And sometimes I was like very, very, very much on the edge with corner cutting, and later on in the video you will be able to see that unfortunately I will have a few track extends, and that's why I will have a few penalty. But speaking of the moments, you can see that Brandon Lee with the fresher tires, actually the same compound but like 4 laps fresher, he goes to my inside, and I didn't really defend against him because I saw no point. Maybe if I can follow him in the DRS or get some nice slipstream or see his lines, maybe it helps me as well to keep the momentum, because today unfortunately I am not fighting for the victory, I am fighting for a P3, P5 finish. And here I defend a little bit against him, but I leave him the space, and he actually pushes me wide, which is not very nice, but you will see from his view that he didn't even hit me. So there was a small lag involved as well, which is like not nice thing from Codemasters in 2018, but I'm sure they are working very hard on these problems to solve. And I got DRS, it was very nice to follow him, he was also faster because he had like fresher compound of tires, and he only pitted like 2 laps later than me, and he also tries to do a one stop. I knew that from the first moment, so we are on different strategy and there is nothing, no point to hold us back. And if I will have the better tires at the end of the race, I will overtake him either way. So I didn't worry at this moment. I just wanted to overtake the traffic as fast as possible and to go with the flow, go with Simp and go with Brandon, because they had an amazing race pace. And behind me there was Photon, my teammate, Steve, there was Hamilton as well, there was Garrix. There were very fast pilots, and as you can see I just followed Timp, and in lap 23 I went to the pit and I chose to put a super soft set of tires. And if you check the map you can see that I have quite a big disadvantage, but we will skip through very very soon and here the action begins. And speaking of the whole season, I think my main objective now is to finish second behind Brandon Lee, because yes, he practices a lot and he's a very very good pilot, the A-Sport champion, so definitely a favorite in any kind of session, in any kind of event. But the field is very strong with Marcel Kiefer, Timp, Hamilton, Bonuhis, Carrick, Graham Caruso. All in all, the second position will not be bad, and it is maybe the wrong mentality, but I need to do like content for you guys, edit these videos, and it takes time. School also takes time, and of course I want to win races, but it's very hard like that. And again, I'm fighting for the 10th position, and actually it's a very nice action. I have much fresher tires, I have softer tires as well compared to the field, and it was a very nice move from me actually on Sir Hamilton. I stayed as close as possible in the fast right-hander, the last corner of the second sector, and I managed to overtake him. And now I attack Bonuhis with DRS. I'm a little bit edgy with the fuel. He didn't defend the inside line, and that's why I just dive in. I both, of course, focus for the exit as well. I didn't want him to make a switchback move on me, and I have P9, and there are still plenty of cars in reach. I have still like 9 laps to go, so it's looking good. And you can see as I skip through the laps, only one or two sectors are skipped, and basically I gain seconds on other Andy. Next opponent I have is Aressi in the Ferrari. Again, I have a much better exit in this fast right-hander. I dive to the inside, he leaves me the space, and I just simply do an overtake. And we faster the video a bit. I catch Fabracer as well. You can see how fast it went. He was like 1.5 seconds ahead, and it took only like 1.5 sectors. But of course, he had like 2 compounds harder tire, and of course an older tire as well. And here he defends the inside line. I couldn't gain a big momentum, and here we make a little bit of contact, and he didn't really leave the space around the outside for me. And here I was very close to damage my front wing. I was shocked for a short moment, but of course I still have time, and I will open the DRS, and this fight is for the P7, so we are definitely getting better and better and better. He defends the inside line, but I dived there very aggressively, and it was like a replication of the Schumacher-Barrichello move in 2010 with the 2 Mercedes. I mean, it was like very satisfying for me, because it was very close to the wall. If you want to just go back and watch it again, you can do it. But with that speed, over 300 km per hour, being that close to the wheel while the other defends the inside line is very satisfying. And here is Carrix in the 5th position. I dive to the inside as well. This was like a very nice move from me again. I think the moves are much simpler than the preparation of the moves, because as I thought, in this track the last 2 sections are very fast. The turbulent air affects your car, mainly the back end, a lot. You really have to focus to put the power drum down to the surface of the track, and I mean, following is so satisfying here if you can follow them close. And I know they have harder compounds, they have older compounds as well, but I still believe that on this track it's very hard to stay that close, because on the exits you really need to focus to make it. And here I attack my teammate for P5 and I go to the inside, and I just thought he would let me pass, because in last GPs when we had the same situation like that, he did let me pass, but here he didn't really leave the space around the outside, so I backed off, and here I have the inside line again, and I managed to make the move. But to be honest, I was a little bit frustrated, because he must have known that I will make the move, but I lost 1.5 seconds to my best lap data, which is like not ideal at all. But of course it's Formula 1 and I didn't ask him at all to let me pass always, so it's not a problem, but I was a little bit surprised. And skipping to lap 34, as you can see, Timp, who didn't make another pit stop, started to lose grip from his tires, and Steve attacks him. I slot between the two cars. I try now from the outside of Steve. I thought he would push me wide, so I went off the track because of like safety, but actually he left me the space, so if I kept my car there, I could have got the overtake already. But here I opened the DRS. I'm very on the edge with fuel. Timp fell back because he has like no tires. I tried from the outside, and now I try to have a very good exit. I have to corrigate a little bit, and I couldn't put the power down as good as I wanted. I try now from the outside. It would have been an amazing move if I could have made it, but I couldn't make it sick. But we still have like 2 sectors left. I will try it as hard as I can. I try to stay very close. I hit the apex very nicely. Steve brakes quite early. He also has a bad tire wear. He was on the opposite strategy of Timp, so he started with softs and put super softs on, and he did a one stop. Again, I try to start the corners from wider, and I try to put it to Rich Mix here, but I realize that I have like no fuel left, so I put it back to lean. I get another corner cutting warning there. I already have like 2 penalty, but you will see the result board. I have a better exit here. I try to go from the outside again, but I slot behind him because I don't like to be pushed wide. And I try it now from the outside to maybe have a better exit, but he covers it cleanly. And because of this battle, as you will be able to see from the result screen, I was overtaken by my teammate by 4 tenths, and we clearly lost that time in this battle because of my penalty. All in all, it was an exciting race. I hope you enjoyed the video. I put big effort in that. And if yes, please don't forget to push the like button. And as always, have a wonderful day and see you in the next one.